Very good afternoon, all Tycoon students here and the students who are going to listen to it from across the country on the business studies paper today. We have our renowned faculty, Kavita Anand. Amma has come here to address all of you on the subject business studies marketing management. Before we get into the session, as usual, we will take the Tycoon leadership pledge. We resolve. Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
We resolve.
We resolve.
To stand as one family.
Stand as one family.
Bound to each other.
Bound to each other.
With love and respect.
Love and respect.
To serve as an army.
To serve as an army.
Courageous and discipline.
Courageous and discipline.
You ever ready to fight against all low tendencies?
Ever ready to fight against all low tendencies.
And false values within and without us.
And false values within and without us.
To live honestly.
To live honestly.
The noble life of sacrifice and service.
The noble life of sacrifice and service.
Producing more than we consume.
Producing more than we consume.
Giving more than we take.
And giving more than we take.
We seek God's grace.
We seek God's grace.
To keep us on the path of virtue.
To keep us on the path of virtue.
Courage and wisdom.
Courage and wisdom.
To bless us with the ability to fulfill our responsibilities.
To bless us with the ability to fulfill our responsibilities.
Towards our society and our world.
Towards our society and our world.
Om Tat Sat.
Om Tat Sat.
My dear friends, please request everybody to mute. Yeah. My dear friends, today we are going to discuss on the most important topic, marketing management. In fact, when we selected this topic, a lot of requests came from across the country for this chapter. I'm not really sure why this request came from across the student fraternity, but I was very sure when the request is coming from the student fraternity, it requires a complete attention by the students. That's all I know. So accordingly, I discussed with Kavita Anandamma, whom I always try to discuss what can we do for the student community, and she immediately accepted that she will do the marketing chapter also. There's a huge response for staffing as well as the staffing chapter handled by Kavita Anandamma, and not only that, for the comprehensive analysis done by CSN Malathi Amma, one of the senior faculties in the country for business studies. This series will continue until the examination is there. We're also planning for panel discussion where all these faculties who have come and lectured you will come on a panel on the last day and then give you insights on each of the chapters and try to have a discussion with you all. There's a unique way of blending the crisis time. It's a unique way to make use of the crisis time where your exams got pushed because of the COVID-19. I am really worried about the COVID-19 now in the country, but at the same time, it's an opportunity for the student community to completely focus on education. So my dear friends, let's all welcome Kavita Anandamma once again for addressing you all on the marketing management. And before we start up the session, before we start the invocation song, let me quote the quotation of Holy Mother Sharada Devi. Holy Mother Sharada Devi said, "As you smell the fragrance of a flower, as you smell the fragrance of a flower while handling it, or the smell of a sandalwood while rubbing it against a stone, so you obtain a spiritual awakening by constantly thinking of God. If you become desireless, you can realize Him right now." My dear friends, the entire education that you're undergoing is for the purpose of selflessness and to contribute to the larger world. And in the path of education, you come across certain experts like Kavita Anandamma, who empower us with that divine teachings. We help us in a critical time. So definitely, you pick up a lot of fragrance in your life in this path. And the great learning is, as you get educated, you should serve. Let me also quote the quotation of Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, Vivekananda and Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Netaji Subhash Chandra Bose, the Indian samurai and the revolutionary who brought the freedom, who worked for the freedom movement in India. He said, Vivekananda had made speeches, written letters, published books, which were available to the layman. But Ramakrishna, the Guru Maharaj, who was almost an illiterate man, had nothing done, nothing of the kind. He had lived his life and had left it to others to explain it. So that is the idea. Ramakrishna Paramahansa would not have published a book, but his teachings are so profound, he was able to create Swami Vivekananda. We're all teachers. I am proud to be a teacher. I may be associated with the government. I may do my consultancy. At the end of the day, whenever I go to public platforms, I say I'm a proud teacher of my student. And that is the pride we have. And that's what Surya sir also says. In all the jobs and the roles he has done, one role that actually satisfies at the end of the day when we go for the sleep is the teaching. Teaching work which we have done. Because it directly empowers the humanity. And you become the torch bearer of the vision that we carry. My dear friends, that's what the quotation of Swami Chinmayananda, who inspired many great leaders in our country. He used to say, in life, there are roles for everyone you meet. In life, there's a role for everyone you meet. Some will test you, some will use you, and some will teach you. The rare, important, amazing person is the one that brings out the best in you. So Kavitama has come here to bring the best in you in the business studies examination. And I'm sure the task of her is a divine task and the God's work. We all should pray tribute to her. Let's all pray tribute to Holy Trio and also the work of Kavita Amma for empowering the students. Over to the Tycoon Tejaswini for the invocation song.
Yadunandana Krishna Madhusudana Yadunandana Krishna Madhusudana Gopika Vallabha Radha Ramana Gopala Gopala Bala Murali Radha Gopala Nandana Bala Shyama Sundara Krishna Janardhana Hare Krishna Janardhana Devaki Bala Yetu Veena Kamsa Vidhamsana Tilaka Dara Yetu Nagda Radhika Jeevana Ananda Madhusudhanaya Ananda Samudra Madhanaya Krishna 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 Gopika Vallabha Radha Ramana Gopala Gopala Bala Murali Dhara Nande Gopala Nandana Bala Shyama Sundara Krishna Janardhana Hare Krishna Janardhana Bala Mukunda Giridari Nana Vilola Rishikesha Manikanta Rasa Vilola Sumedha Madharayanaya Sumedha Vasudevaya Krishna 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 Gopika Vallabha Radha Ramana Gopala Gopala Bala Murali Dhara Radhe Gopala Nandana Bala Shyama Sundara Krishna Janardhana Hare Krishna Janardhana
Thank you Tejaswini and thanks a lot for this divine song. Now I request Kavita Anandamma to take over the proceedings and empower the students on marketing management topic. Thanks a lot, Kavita Amma, for coming again and spending your valuable time with the students here.
Good afternoon, Satya sir and Surya sir and Priya ma'am. Am I audible?
Yes, Amma. Yes, Amma. Huh? Yes, Amma.
I just wanted to check my... Good afternoon, dear children. And Tejaswini, it was so divine listening to your song. And a very nice song to start the session with. Really feeling blessed again to be here. And I think I'll do my best for the students in this chapter, marketing management, which they find really lengthy. So can I just proceed with
Well, go ahead, Amma. You can put up the PPT and then go ahead.
Yes, I would like to start with Swami Vivekananda's quote. We want the education by which character is formed. Strength of mind is increased. The intellect is expanded and by which one can stand on one's own feet. That is what the education is really meant for. So I would like to start with this quote. Yeah, today's chapter being the marketing management, the topic for the revision. So marketing management, children normally feel that there are too many things, too many topics to be covered in this chapter. So I'll just do a small recap of all the topics discussed earlier in your school, in your classroom. Concept of marketing, the first slide here. Marketing is a process whereby people exchange goods and services for money or for something of value to them. And marketing is not merely a post-production activity actually. Marketing doesn't start only when the product is produced and then it is to be sold in the market. Marketing process starts even before the goods are manufactured. Because marketing, as you all know, many of you would have done project on marketing for your business studies. The first step what you would have done is, you would have made a questionnaire, and if you have chosen a product, you first make a questionnaire related to the product, circulate it with some people and find out what is their need, what type of product people are looking for, and then you find out who are the customers whom I'm going to target. Will my product be in demand? Will they like this feature in my product? So marketing starts even before the product is produced. Features of marketing. Here I would like to give a small acronym for remembering the features of marketing. Just remember NCC exchange program. So N stands for needs and wants. C for creating a market offering. And another C for customer value. And the last one being exchange mechanism. Needs and wants. Here I'll just give you a small example to understand the difference between need and want. Need, like if you're hungry, you won't mind eating anything. Like it may be idli. Idli may be so tasty when you're really hungry. Or two slices of bread or a cup of bonvita, whatever it is. Need. You are hungry. You want to eat something. That is what is need. But want. Want is, I am hungry, I want to eat pizza, I want to eat a burger, I want to have some chili paratha. So then it becomes wants. So that is the difference between need and want. Need is the basic thing for a human survival, like a shelter, food, clothing, all the basic needs. And wants are your desires, what you want above your needs. The next part is, so features of marketing, the first feature should be definitely need and want. Before they start the marketing a product, before they start venturing into markets, they first need to analyze the need and want of the customers, all the organization. The next thing is creating a market offering. The latest example what I can tell is any electronic gadgets when people are going to buy, like for example, if they are going to buy a mobile or a laptop, so many features the customer look into. Does it have this battery? What is the gadget? How is the camera going to be? What are all the additional features in this particular device? So any home appliances also. We just look into so many features. So creating a market offering. So first of all the features which will satisfy the needs of the customer should be there in the product. The next one is customer value. The main purpose of market is customer. Yeah, customer is the king. Customer's preference should be given the priority. What will the customer prefer? And will the customer prefer my product in front of my competitor's product? That has to be kept in mind. The last one is exchange mechanism. Yeah, before we start actually going into detail into the marketing chapter, you must understand the concept of exchange mechanism. Whenever we say marketing, there should be a buyer and a seller. The seller offers the product and the buyer they'll pay money, or in anything, the value of the product being offered by the seller. Then both the party should have the freedom to accept or reject. The buyer should be, the seller should not be compelling, and the buyer should not be compelled to buy the product. Okay, should not be forced or compelled. And other parties offer. And the parties should be willing to enter into transactions with each other willingly. It should not be forcibly done. So this is an important concept. So features of marketing, please remember the acronym NCC Exchange Program. So NCC Exchange, you'll remember this, needs and wants, creating a market offering, customer value, and the last one, exchange mechanism, four features of marketing. The next one, see, this was the first question I think in last year's board business studies paper. What can be marketed? Normally, students think that only goods can be marketed. So here I have given some examples of various things which can be marketed. Normally, you all know goods, watches, cars, cosmetics, any sports equipment, mobile, electronic gadgets, all these things can be marketed, fine. Next is services, hotels, insurance, services can be marketed. Events like ISL, IPL are marketed. Experiences, when you go to an amusement park, you enjoy various rides there. So it's an experience. That experience is being marketed. Persons, like celebrity marketing. Places, I think most of you would have seen this Incredible India ad. So again, like a visit, have a tour to the northeast places of India. You see some ads. So Incredible India ad. What are they marketing there? They are marketing the place. Ideas. Recently, I had come across this in the TV. Fir Muskurayega India. I think most of you would have seen this. So they are just marketing the idea. Then properties. Property here, I mean the intangible thing like shares and debentures. They are marketed. Information, like again another ad, UNICEF ad is being shown in the TV where people are, they request the people for contribution towards the child education. Information is being marketed. So this was a 1 mark question where they had given a case study about a place being marketed. So people cannot write, student cannot write tourism and all that. They have to just mention the place is being marketed. So what can be marketed is an important concept to be understood by all of you. What and all can be marketed. So like this, everything can be marketed. Not necessary, there should be some product which only can be marketed. The next one is, who is a marketer? Any person who takes more active part in the process of exchange. It may not be always the seller, it may not be always the buyer. Whoever is taking most active part in the process of the exchange, he can be called as a marketer. One question here to try out. When you go out for dinner in a restaurant, who will be considered as a marketer? The restaurant owner, you, or both restaurant owner and yourself, or none? When you go out for dinner in a restaurant, who will be considered as a marketer? You're going to the restaurant, it's the restaurant owner's responsibility to make you feel comfortable in the restaurant, and you should like the food there, and you should be again going to the same place next time to dine. So here the marketer will be the restaurant owner. Hope you all are understanding this concept. Now next we move on to functions of marketing. Functions of marketing, there are few numbers, points which has to be remembered. I have tried my level best to give you an acronym supporting some pictures for the acronym. Like you can remember it using general manager of PSP, made a big purchase by presenting a PowerPoint to Standard Chartered. I repeat it again, general manager of PSP, made a big purchase by presenting a PPT to Standard Chartered. The first step is gathering and analyzing market information, G. In general manager, the first one, gathering and analyzing market information. So first step in the marketing is functions of marketing. First of all, find out whether people need your product. What are the strengths? What are all the opportunities and threats? What are all the opportunities and threats? So first find out SWOT analysis. I think many of you would have heard about SWOT analysis: strength, weakness, opportunities, and threat. What is the strength of my product? What are all the weakness? And how many competitors are there in the market already for this product? What are all the opportunities? Opportunities means where is opportunity for my product? How much my product will be influencing customer in the market? And then the threat. Who are all the competitors? What are all the additional features they'll be looking into my product in comparison to the competitor's product? So first step is gathering and analyzing market information. The second one is marketing planning. In marketing planning, what we normally do is, am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Am I audible?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Okay. Gathering and analyzing market information, that is the first step. You look for the opportunities, you look for the threats, you look for the strength, you look for the weakness. So SWOT analysis and all you do, and then you find out whether my product will be successful in the market. Then the marketing planning. What is marketing planning? The second step. Here, what we do is, for example, this time I have achieved 10% target. If I'm producing LED televisions, okay, 10% target I have achieved. So next year I plan for 20%. I increase my target. I increase my target of production. I increase my target of sales. So thus I make some market planning. The third step is product designing and development. What I'm talking about you now is the PSP, product designing and development, standardization and grading, packaging and labeling. So product designing and development, I design my product, I add all the features. So all these steps I'm going to talk to you in detail further about product, price, promotion, place. All this I'm going to discuss in detail. I'll just give you a brief idea about all these steps. The next one is standardization and grading. You produce a product with some specific quality so that all the output, whatever you are making, how many of your products you are manufacturing, everything will be of the same standard, same quality, same grade. So you grade it. And then packaging and labeling. Hope everyone will understand packaging plays a vital role. Packaging and labeling plays a great role in promotion of product nowadays. Looking at the packaging only, like Uncle Lay's chips, your chips packets and all, and the chocolates, everything, the attractive packaging and the labeling only attracts people to buy the product. Branding. The moment you say brand, Adidas, Reebok, Nike, normally we go for branded products. Branding is done. Then pricing of product. Yes, there are so many factors which has to be discussed in detail when we come to pricing of product. How do we go about pricing of product? What are all the factors which affect the pricing of product? All this I'll discuss in detail in further slides. Next is promotion. Promotion, what are all the means? What are all the ways I can promote my product? What are all the schemes I will use for promotion? Then physical distribution. Okay. The tea is produced in Assam. It cannot stay in Assam only, and it cannot be locally distributed only in Assam. We get Assam tea even in Tamil Nadu. That is physical distribution. How do I distribute? What are all the channels of distribution which I'm going to use for physical distribution? Then comes transportation. How it is going to be transported from one area to another area, from one country to another country? How is it going to be managed? Then storage or warehousing. Yes, all the goods which are produced are not immediately consumed. There is some time gap between the production and the consumption period. So that has to be adjusted only by warehousing. That is to be, the time gap has to be managed, like seasonal demand for the products. All this has to be managed only with warehousing. The next one, the last one is customer support service, which plays a vital role nowadays, after sales service. The product cannot be sold and the customer cannot be left like that. No customer will go and buy the product if they are not guaranteed 5 years warranty for the motor, or say 5 years after sales service. Every year we will do some service, or you enter into some AMC, they say, actually annual maintenance contract and all that. So customer support service is very vital in marketing nowadays. So I hope this acronym will be useful for you to remember functions of marketing. So just remember, general manager of PSP made a big purchase by presenting a PPT to Standard Chartered. Shall we move on to the next slide? Understanding based question. A question here. The process of marketing involves creating a market offering and satisfying the needs and wants of the present and the potential buyers. Potential buyers in future, they may buy our product. The real question, how to create a market offering? Suppose after gathering and analyzing market information, a profitable business opportunity is seen by some firm in the field of producing soft drinks to develop and market a new brand of soft drinks. The firm takes a number of important decisions, for example, whether to go for any collaboration with a foreign manufacturer of soft drinks or whether to produce for the local market or for a wider market. What will be the feature of the new market so that it is attractive to the target customers? Whether the drink will be packed in glass bottles or plastic cans? What will be the name? What will be the brand name of the drink? At what price it will be sold? At par with the price of which, what is the competitor's price? And so on. Identify and explain the two features of marketing discussed above. Identify and explain any four functions of marketing discussed above. So here, the needs and wants, if we just go back, we have discussed about the needs and wants of the consumer, and then creating a market offering. What are all the additional features I can give with this offering? And then the second part of the question was identify and explain any four functions of marketing discussed above. So gathering and analyzing market information, marketing planning has been done, product designing and development, packaging, branding, pricing of the product, all these are the steps which have been completed. Next, we move on to the marketing management philosophies. Okay, we were just talking about what are all the functions of marketing, what are the things to be done. If it is marketing, it's a wider term. So how much we have to put in our effort, what is to be done. So there are some philosophies under marketing management. So what is the philosophy? What should be my concept? Am I going to have product based or production based or selling concept, or it is going to be societal marketing concept? So what type of concept I'm going to, what is going to be my marketing management philosophy? Every organization must decide on this. So marketing philosophy is actually a traditional concept. We have production, product and selling. Earlier days we were having only these concepts. Production, like they will focus only with the quantity of production of products, volume of production, how much I produce, that's all. Product, focus on the product, then selling, somehow push the product in the market. That was the selling concept. But now new modern concepts, two more concepts have been involved, the marketing concept and the societal marketing concept. And the marketing concept, we'll see that consumer is the king. What is the need of the consumer? Consumer will play a major role in the marketing. And societal marketing concept, along with the consumer, the social welfare of the society, the social welfare of the community. So what am I doing to the society through this marketing? Okay, the first one we'll look into marketing philosophy, the first concept being production concept. Here, the focus was in this, actually in earlier days, it was production concept, like there were very less manufacturers, very less producers. How much ever they produce, whatever they produce was being sold. People were having not much of competitors there. So if they produce a quality good, okay, there will be only one type of product available in the market. They won't have a wider choice. Like if, for example, if we now go to a departmental store, if we are going to look for someone drink for the even like a Bonvita. If we are looking at Bonvita, you'll have Bonvita, you'll have a Milo, you'll have a Boost, you have Complan, you have Horlicks, and again, so many flavors in each and every type of drink. But earlier days, it was not like that. One health drink in the market, one health drink alone is available, one variety is available. So people normally, what they do is, people were not having a wider choice. So at that time, this concept was applicable, production concept. They were constantly producing the same type of product. Since the demand was so huge, whatever they were producing were being sold in the market. So production was emphasized, more amount, more quantity of producing, the larger quantity of production. So availability and affordability of product was the key to success here. And they were, company was just thinking to create one type of product which will be of a greater quality, and everyone will buy the same product. They didn't have much of choice. Here I've given a few examples for the production concept. So what people do is normally when you have the basic commodities such as salt or some water, electricity and all this. So what people will do normally here is the basic requirement, you need the salt, you need soap, you need toothpaste. You don't have many choice. Mostly in rural economy, people used to buy water is available. So people don't have much of choice to choose among n number of products. At that time, they will focus only in the production of the product. How much volume of production is focused there? The next one is product concept. Product concept, as we were developing slowly, the market was developing. There were various competitors coming into the market. At that time, the product concept came into force. Like product concept is, how can I make my product the best product in the market? How can I add some more features to the product? How can I make people buy my product? How can I be competitive in the market? How can I survive in the market? What should be the quality? What is the consumer preference? So all the focus was shifted to make the product very innovative. How do I make my product the best product in the market? Here the focus was in the product. Product concept, to just see what they do is, mostly the focus was fully over the product. How have, yes, like for example, earlier we were having black and white TV, then slowly we shifted to color TV. Okay, color TV itself was in the 80s, color TV was a very big thing. Like for people those who are in the 80s, they think color TV was too much. Actually, portable TV also will make people happy. But after that, the concept of LCD. Okay, LCD has gone up, LED, and then smart TV. So how people change, the product has been enhanced from one small TV to this level, to LED, smart TV and all that. So product concept. So mostly they focus with the advancement of product. What are all the additional features I can give to the product? So how I can make my product the best. And customers have started choosing. Nowadays, customers started choosing. They look into so many features for the amount they are paying. They see whether it is worth buying this product. If I am buying this product, is it worth? If I am going to pay 10,000, the customer will not pay just like that. Even for 10 rupees, they will see whether it is valuable or not. Should I go for this product or not? Because I have another product which has some additional features for the same amount I am going to pay. So there are so many competitors. So product concept is playing a vital role. The next one is the selling concept. We have just seen the production concept where volume of production is the focus. Then the product concept, where the product is the limelight. And now we move on to the selling concept. Here, selling concept, what they do is they convince the customer. They somehow see that the product is being sold. They satisfy the customer by giving all the key features of the product. They convince the customer. They make them understand. So here, when we say selling concept, the key role is sales promotion. Somehow they promote the sales. Like you would have seen many places, like they put up some stalls in the malls and all that. People call you and people tell you the features of the product. They see that you're buying, you're interested, and they at least ask you to, they give you a form, ask you to fill up the form and all that. And then they try to contact and somehow they promote the product and they will convince and they will ask you to buy the product. Under the selling concept, somehow the customer should be persuaded. Somehow you should convince the customer, adopt all the sales promotion techniques and promote your product and sell the product. Under the selling concept, here I have just given you a gift. Customer, just pick up, choose the customer, grab the customer. That is the meaning here. Grab the customer, make them buy the product, make them feel convinced by telling all the features about your product. Customer should not be dissatisfied. Satisfy the customer and somehow make your product move in the market. That is the selling concept. The next one is marketing concept. If you have to understand the marketing concept, please go through the five pillars I've given here in this slide. The marketing concept means you have to give importance for the customer's need. What does the customer need? What are they looking for? Will they be satisfied if I give all these features in my product? So customer is the king. Give more priority for the customer's needs, taste, like, preference and all that. So they are our customer is the king of the market. Okay. So what you have to do is remember these five pillars for marketing concept. Identification of target market, who is going to be your target market or who is going to be your consumer, like which age group you are going to look into. Like if you are going to look for some toys, okay, you have to immediately fix up the age group to whom I am. So okay, watches, which age group will prefer this type of watch or some gadgets or some other, like according to the product, you have to identify the target consumer. Whom am I going to target with my product? First, identify your target. Next, understanding the needs and wants. Do a survey, conduct a survey. Find out what is the need, what is their want, what are they expecting from our product. Then create a product which will satisfy the needs of all the customers in large scale. Then satisfying needs better than competitors. Okay, this is the most important thing. First, find out what are all the competitors manufacturing. What are their products? What features they have? Okay, apart from them, to make my product unique, what should an additional feature for the product, what I am designing? So should it have this feature? Then will the customer like this feature? Will it be useful for them? So do that. And then finally, profitability through customer satisfaction being the focal point. Customer satisfaction is the focal point in the marketing concept. Finally, the customer should be satisfied buying my product. His needs should be satisfied. He should be happy buying it. He should be paying money and buying the product happily. And he should be recommending more customers to me. So here the customer is the focal point. The next one, of course, nowadays people are looking for this. Normally every organization is going for corporate social responsibility, what they call societal marketing concept. Any business organization should keep in mind that the business organization exists in the society. They should be giving back something to the society. They cannot be only profit. The business cannot be only profit. The business cannot be existing only for profit maximization. They should take care of the welfare of the society. The customer should be satisfied. Satisfaction of the customer is important. Society's welfare is important. And the company should also be making profit. That is the triangular thing that I have shown. So all the three aspects should be taken care of. The concept of welfare of the society, the customer satisfaction, and the organization for existing in the market, they should be definitely making profit. So all the three aspects of societal marketing concept, when they say, there should be some clue in the case study which is talking about the welfare of the society. And the same way, the previous concept, when they say marketing concept, there should be more, the case study will give more importance for the customer's choice. So there may be case studies in the question paper where you need to identify, read the paragraph thoroughly and find out what concept are they talking about under marketing concept. And sometimes there may be two or three concepts covered in the case study. But once you read, just pay attention to the key points what I've told you so that you can just immediately relate the concept. Here is a small match the following event. Match the marketing philosophies against their respective focus. So what should be the focus? Just for you to understand, production concept. So they will focus, the production concept will focus only with the quantity of product. And then the product concept will focus with the quality of the product. And the selling concept, somehow persuade the buyer to purchase. And marketing concept, of course, customer needs. One more concept what I spoke here to you is societal marketing concept. Welfare of the society, something to the society. So just go through this and the following. So here the solution for this will be option 2, because A4 and B3, C1 and B2, option 2. So production concept, quantity of product, product concept, quality of the product, selling concept, somehow persuade the buyer to purchase, marketing concept will focus only with the customer needs. Now we move on to marketing mix. What is marketing mix? So whenever a marketing, whenever a business organization is going to offer a product in the market, then it has to have all this mix. So factors affecting the marketing decisions, two categories here, mainly, please remember, controllable factors, non-controllable factors. Controllable factors mostly which can be controlled by the firm, within the firm, like the brand name. For example, here I've given you the brand name which can be decided by the firm. Non-controllable factors, external factors. Controllable, internal, within the firm, within the organization. the management can bring into control very easily. But non-controllable factors not in the hands of the management, not in the hands of the business organization. It is external to them, which they cannot control. Like, for example, government policies, the competitors' price, all those are non-controllable because you cannot decide what the competitor should set his product price as. So all those are non-controllable factors beyond the control of the organization. Elements of marketing mix, most of you will definitely know this: product, price, place, promotion. 4 P's of marketing we say normally: product, price, place, promotion. We'll just look into each and everything one by one in detailed manner, all the 4 P's of marketing. First, we look into product. Whenever we say product, immediately what we look into is like, what are all the important product decisions? When I say product, okay, what is that product? It means goods or services. Why I say here goods or services? There are some services also we undertake. Okay, so it need not be always a physical product which is tangible and we use. Healthcare is service. Insurance is a service. Okay, so product or service. Both anything of value which is offered to the market for sale. Okay, now here I have given you an example for the product Amul, which is producing all type of products, milk, ghee, butter, cheese and all that. Important product decisions: branding, packaging, labeling. Please remember BPL, branding, packaging, labeling. So what I thought is, first I'll discuss everything related to product, then I'll move on with the next P. First product, then price, then promotion, place and promotion. So here we'll first move on with product and all the aspects related to product I'll finish, and then we'll move on to the next P. So under product, the most important concept what you people should know is branding, packaging, labeling. Branding. What is branding? Is giving a name, sign or symbol. And here you have to know one important thing. What is the concept of generic name? Generic name refers to the name of the class of the product. For example, here I have given car. Car means BMW, Honda City, Audi, etc. But car is the generic name here. That is the general name. That is the class. The name of the class is car. Like if I say biscuits, okay, or chocolates, all that are generic name. Under chocolate, you have various types. Then it is the brand name and all that. So car is the generic name here. BMW, Honda, City, Audi and all are the brand names. Then terms relating to branding. What are all the terms relating to branding you must know? The first one is brand. Then the brand name. Then brand mark. Under brand name, you will have brand. Under brand, you will have brand name and brand mark and trademark. First, we will just go to brand. Under brand, you have brand name, brand mark. Brand name is the verbal component of a brand. And brand mark, part of a brand which can be recognized only but cannot be spoken. Like the symbol, the drawing what you see. Brand name is the name written. Okay. And brand mark, like if Puma is written, P-U-M-A, Puma. Okay, there's another symbol under brand name. Okay. So that is like a cheetah symbol. So that is the brand mark. And then the next one is trademark. The part of the brand name which has been given legal protection, that is called as trademark. So please know the difference between brand name and the trademark. Like trademark, the legal, if the brand name is given a legal protection, then we call it as trademark. Here I would like to mention that. Now, like for example, that if you take, I have just shown some examples for branding here. When the moment you see the brand name here, you'll identify the product like Amazon, Google, Coca-Cola, Nike, YouTube, McDonald's. Okay. So all these are popular brand names. When these brand names are being registered, you will see one symbol R or you will see one symbol TM inside a circle. Then it is trademark. That means it has been legally registered. Okay. So advantages of branding to the marketers and to the customers. To the marketers, enables product differentiation, ease an introduction of a new product. Any product which has to be introduced, if it has an attractive brand name, immediately people think of buying it. Differential pricing. See, always branded products will be highly priced. But people trust because when people go by brand because they think if I go for branded products, we need not compromise on the quality. also helps in advertising and display program, and to the customers helps in product identification, ensures quality, status symbol, of course Reebok shoes, Adidas. Why people go for Adidas shoes or Adidas t-shirts? All this because of the quality, and it's a status symbol. You see the symbol there in Adidas, okay, it's of a good quality, it's a status symbol. Here I've just given some trademark and brand mark. Trademark, as you see on the screen, will have that R circled or TM circle, and all the brand mark, few important brand marks I've shown here. Maggie is a generic name of a product or brand name of a product, brand mark of a product, or none of the above. Maggie cannot be a generic name. What should be the generic name here? Noodles. Maggie is a brand name. So of course, Maggie is a brand name. The solution should be option B. The next question, second question is, Ambipure, Duracell, Pantene, etc. are different brands of products manufactured by. The companies are given here: Hindustan Unilever Limited, Tata, Procter & Gamble, Godrej Consumer Products. Of course, everyone will know Ambipure, Duracell, Pantene and all, it is HUL, Hindustan Unilever Limited. So there can be some MCQs like this for you. All popular brands I've just mentioned here. Okay, characteristics of a good brand name. Okay, a brand name should be short, easy to pronounce, spell. It should not be complicated. Everyone should immediately register in the mind. Like I've given you example here, LG, Rin, Vim. It should not be lengthy. It should not have complicated spellings. So a brand name should be short, easy to pronounce, and easy to recognize, understand, and immediately look at the product and buy. A brand name should suggest the product's benefits and qualities related with our current situation now. Example, I see this ad frequently nowadays in the TV. Pankaja Kasturi, breathe easy. The moment we see this, we know what is the purpose of this product. A brand name should suggest what is the benefit you will get out of this product. What is this product meant for? Pankaja Kasturi, breathe easy. Then a brand name should be distinctive. Yes, always I've seen most students going for only Wildcraft products. Even nowadays they advertise for the Wildcraft mask. Very popular. Wildcraft, the name itself is so distinctive. Chosen name should have staying power. Example, Lifebuoy. Lifebuoy, I know for the past so many years, the same name, it is sustaining the same name. Brand name should be versatile. Example, Colgate tooth. Like Colgate. Colgate is the name. With Colgate, you can add on the various products name. Like Colgate toothpaste, Colgate mouthwash, Colgate brush, and so many other products. So Colgate is the common name there. So the brand name should be versatile to continue with so many line of products. Other products in the same line. Okay. Next, should be adaptable to packaging and care. Hope these examples. With these examples, you can remember the characteristics of a good brand name. The moment you see LG, okay, it has to be short. Pankaja Kasturi, breathe easy. That means then Wildcraft, something distinctive. Staying long time. Remember Lifebuoy. And brand names that you can recall the characteristics of a good brand name. Okay. I've given you an example for packaging. It's a vital role, attracts people to buy the product nowadays. Looking at the wrapper, the colorful wrapper, the way people think that why don't I buy and try once. So packaging plays a vital role. So packaging refers to the act of designing and producing the container or wrapper of product. Majority of the products are successful nowadays in the market just because of the packaging. And children often get attracted towards attractive packaging. The first one is the primary package. Primary package means the package which is in immediate contact with the product. That is the immediate container. The secondary package, like for example, here I have shown you the example of a sauce packet, a single packet, and then 10 packets in one pouch. And that pouch, many pouches have been put in the cardboard box. That is the third level. So first level, primary, then secondary. Then the transportation level is the cardboard box. What we pack, the cardboard box for the transportation package. So these are all the levels of packaging. Sham bought a pain relieving ointment after seeing it being displayed in the chemist shop. The ointment tube was packed in a cardboard box. Identify the different levels of packaging on the pain relieving medicine when it was purchased by Shah. See the ointment tube. Here I have shown you the move tube. The tube is the primary package there. And the tube cannot come like that. So it has to be handled carefully. And that will be put into another cardboard box. That will become the cardboard box becomes a secondary packaging. And the ointment tube, that becomes a primary packaging. Hope you all are clear with primary and secondary packaging. And here one more thing will be the transportation packaging. Like this move, first in the tube, then it will be put in the cardboard box. And like a 10 move boxes, this cardboard box will be arranged in another bigger box to enable us to transport it to some other place. That will be the next level of packaging. Functions of packaging. What are all the functions of packaging? Here I have given you a picture with which I can just explain you the various functions of packaging. First one, product identification. Hope this picture shows you all the functions. You can identify the product the moment you see the package. Like it's a pack of gems. Okay, it's a chocolate here, or it's a health drink, or it's a bubble gum, it's a chewing gum, and all that. The next, product protection. Yeah, how to protect the product. The product has been produced. Okay, all these eatables, it cannot be thrown just like that. You have to protect the product. Okay, so what they do is they have multi-level of packaging. They have first one aluminium foil, they have one small plastic cover, then they have one outer wrapper, then they have one cardboard box. So it protects the product. The shelf life of the product is long lasting because of this packaging. Then product promotion. The moment you see the packaging only, you feel that you are getting attracted towards the products and you feel that you need to buy the product. Facilitating use of product. Look at the bone meter jar there. It's so easy to handle. So that makes the product to be handled easily. So facilitating use of products. So packaging functions, product identification, identify the product, protect the product. And it is, nowadays people go and all the products are displayed in the department also. Everything is put in the shelf. Only the packaging act as a tool of promotion. There is no person standing near all the product and explaining you everything, all the features of the product. The product itself should make you feel that you have to buy the product. So product promotion is done only because of the packaging. Then facilitating use of product. The next one, importance of packaging. Here I have given you an acronym, RSVP. And mostly in the invitation cards, you would have seen RSVP. It's a French word. It's a French word. RSVP, remember this for importance of packaging. The first importance being rising standards of health and sanitation. Just imagine if it is not properly packed, if it is not properly sealed, will anyone buy the goods? So people normally go and trust. Nowadays, people don't buy even grocery from the nearby shop where everything is kept in loose bags and all that. We don't buy. We don't buy products which are being wrapped in a newspaper and given to us. People generally prefer goods which are packed and stored. That's why nowadays we buy frequently all snacks which are packed. Because we believe that it is safe for our health. That may be less adulteration. And the next one is R, rising standards R. And yes, self-service outlets. Just now I told you. Self-service outlets. Everywhere you go, you pick up the product, you buy. The product packaging itself acts as a promotional tool. Innovational opportunity. Now here I have mentioned an example of long shelf life milk. Yes, nowadays you see that the shelf life of milk is for 6 months or 90 days. For 180 days, you can store a milk packet. So look at the innovation here. So innovational opportunities, packaging improves the product's lifetime. And then product differentiation. How do you make difference between the product? It is because of the packaging. You are able to make difference between the product. So remember, for importance of packaging, the word RSVP given in the invitation. Rising standards of health and sanitation are, yes, for self-service outlet. And the innovational opportunity, where we and product differentiation. Labeling. Here I've given Kinder Joy. I don't know how many of you will like Kinder Joy. But it's an attractive chocolate, I feel, because it has a toy inside. So labeling refers to designing the label to be put on the package. Functions of labeling. I thought this picture will itself explain you what are all the functions of labeling. First of all, it has to specify what is the content, what is the product content that has to be done. First thing is identify the product, Kinder Joy. It's a yummy snack with toy. So identify the product. Immediately you can identify what is the product. And next you have to identify the content of the product that is given in the labeling. And then grading of product. What are all the ingredients? What is the grading? And sometimes when I see here grading, actually, what normally we get in the market nowadays when you buy and go to buy rice variety, you'll have 100 grams. So many varieties of rice. Grading is done. This is the premium quality, supreme quality, super fine rice and all that. So all this grading will be mentioned in the labeling. And then promotion, help to promotion. When children look at this product only, they'll be tempted to buy because it says Kinder Joy. You have a toy inside, you have a snack. So it helps in promotion of the product. Labeling helps in promotion of the product. And last but not the least, giving the whatever is as per the law, whatever statutory warning has to be given or whatever instruction has to be given to handle this product carefully, that is mentioned. Here, I think in this listen, they would have mentioned it is not appropriate for age less than 3 years. So that is an example for this, like providing whatever is required, providing information required by law should be stated on the product label. Otherwise, handle with care. Most of you would have come across that, handle with care. Or so all these statutory warning, whatever is to be given will be given legally, whatever should be there, all the details will be given in the labeling and the expiry date, the manufacturing date, what are all the ingredients, what are the calories you will get from eating this if it is a food product, food related product. So labeling plays a vital role. So we have seen branding, then packaging, then labeling. BPL, buy one and get one free, is printed on the label. The moment we see BOGF, immediately everyone will feel buying the product. Okay, because I buy one, I get one free. What more I need? Is printed on the label of the package of a mosquito repellent. State the labeling function being performed. It's product promotion. It's promoting the product. You buy one product, you get a similar product free. So definitely it is acting as a promotion tool. The next, we move on to the next P. All this, on all the previous slides, we were looking into the first P, that is the product. Under product, we had seen branding, packaging, labeling. So BPL is done. Now we move on to the second P, price. We are discussing about marketing mix, the four P's. The first one being done product, the second one is price. Okay, very important. Nothing can be given free of cost. For everything, you need to pay money, which plays a major role. What is the price for my product? I have decided, brand is decided, labeling is done, packaging, all this is fine. What will be my price of the product? Will I be able to cover the cost? Will I be able to survive in the market with this price? Who are all my competitors? How am I going to fix the price? So important pricing decisions. So here I will give you the acronym for this. Savings deposit and fixed deposit, SD and FD. First point being setting the pricing objective. So first of all, the organization should set, if I'm going to give this price for my product, it has to be related with your objective. Okay, what will be my objective? Profit maximization, or I have to increase my sales, or I have to increase what? So, or I have to get more customers, let my price be set at a lower level. So what are all my object? What is my objective first of all? Decide on that. Next, determining pricing strategies. Hope you all would have read this in economics, if I'm not wrong, economics, ENT. This topic comes. Penetration pricing and skimming pricing. Penetration pricing is from lowest price to capture a large market. So penetration pricing, the initially when you're a startup, when you're introducing a new product, you're a small firm, you're just starting, then you will believe in capturing the market by quoting a lesser price. And once you are established, you have grown in the market, that time you can go for high price. So skimming pricing is setting high price to maximize the profit. Here I have given you the example of Harley Davidson. Skimming pricing, high price. The bike is really highly priced, like max of 4.5 lakhs, the starting price should be. So okay, high price, but the people trust Harley Davidson, immediately people would like to buy. But for penetration pricing, I have given you the example of Saravana stores. lower price. People go because Saravana stores normally in all the products, whatever they are, whether it is clothing or gold or it's grocery, anything, they have the lowest price. What they do is they have huge number of customers. Their market is very well. They have large number of customers. People go and buy and they make huge amount of profit by making their sales quantity is, the volume is increased by quoting low price. So penetration pricing, skimming pricing, just remember these examples for you to recall. Next one is, so savings deposit is over. Analyzing the factors determining price. Okay, what are all the factors which I have to keep in mind when I am determining the price of my product? What are all the various factors that has to be kept in mind when I am going to price them? So for example, here I have told you, the competitor's price has to be kept in mind before I fix up the price for my product. Then it is fixing the price. Okay, I have analyzed all this. I have seen what is my objective. I have seen what are all the various strategies I am using, whether penetration pricing or skimming pricing. What is the strategy I am going to adopt? Then I have analyzed the factors, the various factors which will determine my price, like the competitor's price and what are all the various products with additional features available. Then I move on with fixing the price. I fix the price for my product. Then decisions in respect of discounts. The last point, if they are going to buy in bulk, what will be the discount? What will be my trade discount? What will be my cash discount? You make decisions on discount being given for your product. Okay, next point, we move on to factors affecting price determination. Very important concept. What are all the various factors which determine the price of your product? Just remember this acronym, GM CUP Square. Remember this acronym, GM CUP Square. I'll just explain you. It is not in the same order here in the slide, but let me just explain you all the factors. It need not be in the same order also, children. It can be in any order because it's not a process. You can just remember all the factors using this acronym, GM CUP Square. First one, G, governmental regulations. What are all the factors which will affect your price? The first point you can write here is government rules and regulations. Please remember, any business organization, the MRP would have seen that it cannot be, maximum retail price cannot be above this limit. You have to follow the norms given by the government. There are some rules and regulations imposed by the government. So you have to follow that. So government rules and regulations. The next one is M. M stands for marketing method. What is the marketing method? What are all the distribution channels I'm going to use? What is the sales promotion technique I'm going to use? So what is my marketing method, my distribution system, how much I'm going to spend on distribution of this product, how am I going to handle my sales promotion for this product, how much I'm going to spend on advertisement, or how much I'm going to spend on rebate, discount, and all this. So what is the marketing method? That is the second point. First one, G for government rules and regulations. Second one, M for marketing methods. Next, C, the competition. If there is a heavy competition for my product, then definitely my price should be less. If there is no competition at all for the product, then my price can be little higher. If I have too many competitors, like biscuits, chocolates, you have competitors like anything. So you have to go in for a lower price if you have to survive in the market. So look at the competition. The next point, C for competition. Next, U, we move on to U, utility and demand. So for example, if the demand is inelastic, the demand is doesn't change, the demand for the product is constant, then I can definitely go for higher price. Whether the price is high or low, like basic commodities like milk, people will buy. Even if the packet is going to be sold for 50 rupees a packet, or half liter packet is 50 rupees, but we need milk, we buy. So if the demand is going to be inelastic, the price can be higher. So utility and the demand of the product has to be kept in mind when we decide the price of a product. The next one is, we have the last one, P square. There are two P's here. Profit maximization is objective. It is on the objective profit maximization. What is my pricing objective? Pricing objective if my pricing objective is going to be profit maximization, then definitely I'll go for higher price. But no, my objective is obtaining market share leadership. I want to be the leader in the market. Okay, I'll start with the lower price and survive in the competitive market, then lower price. So that is the way. So pricing objective is the next P, stands for pricing objective. So what will be my objective? Based on my objective only, I'll decide on the price of the product. The last one, P squared. So another P, product cost. When I am selling a product, when I am manufacturing a product, I must look into all the costs what I have incurred in manufacturing that particular product. I should not be selling as a business person, as a businessman. No businessman will do any business for a loss. Definitely, I should not be spending any money out of my pocket and doing business. I should be looking at some amount of profit. So what is my product cost? How much the product cost to me? About that, I should be earning at least to some 5% or some 6% or 10%. There should be some profit margin for me for business. What is the acronym? GM Cup Square. So G stands for government rules and regulations. M stands for market method. C for competition, U for utility and demand, P for one P for pricing objective. What is my objective? If I'm going to do profit maximization or I'm going to obtain capture the market or I'm going to survive in the market with what asked but not the least, the product cost, which has to be really kept in mind because you should not be spending anything out of your pocket. So you need to cover the cost of the product at least when you're making a business, when you're doing a business. Hope you're clear with this. Next P, pricing is done. Product is done. Pricing is done. Next, we move on to place or physical distribution. Both mean the same children. How the product is going to reach the right place to the right people at the right time. How am I going to take my product? How am I going to move my product, the physical movement of goods from the producer to the consumer, that has to be taken care of. Place or physical distribution is the next one. Okay, here, please remember an acronym for components of physical distribution, World Trade Organization International, WTOI. W stands for warehousing. Components of physical distribution, I repeat, W stands for warehousing. T stands for transportation. O for order processing. And I for inventory control. Inventory control is maintaining the right amount of stock. Because when the consumers are placing order, you cannot take the order and then inform the manufacturer for manufacturing the product or producing the product, then reaching it will take so many months. So you have to maintain ample inventory before you take the order. So here, I would just like to explain in brief about all these four components. The first one is, W is for storage. How do you store your product? How do you adjust the time gap between the production time and the consuming time? The product cannot be produced and immediately consumed. For example, the woolen clothes will be required only during winter season. It doesn't mean that you have to produce only in the month of winter. You cannot produce sweaters and you cannot produce umbrellas only during rainy season. Umbrellas are being produced throughout, manufactured throughout the year. Sweaters are produced throughout the year, manufactured throughout the year. But warehousing, that is how the warehousing function comes, you store. Next is transportation, how to move the goods from one place to another. And then order processing. Order processing is nothing but like placement. Like when you place order in Amazon, you would have said place the order. So how do you collect the order from the consumer, from the customer, and how do you make the order reach from the customer to the manufacturer? And the last one is inventory control. Maintain proper inventory control to satisfy your customer's needs. Okay, next we move on to channels of distribution. When I say place or physical distribution, channels of distribution plays a vital role. There are different channels of distribution. There can be a direct channel from the producer to the consumer directly, or there can be producer, wholesaler, retailer, consumer, or producer, agent, wholesaler, retailer, consumer, a three-level channel. So here I have shown you the functions performed by channels of distribution. Here again, I have tried giving one acronym. NASA at par. NASA at par with ISRO. I've just given it as an example here. NASA at par. So N stands for negotiation. What the warehousing do? What the distribution channels, what do they do? They act as a link between the consumer and the manufacturer. They negotiate the price for the product and they act on behalf of the consumer and they act on behalf of the consumer to the manufacturer and get a price fixed. And then first one, N is for negotiation. The next one is allocation. Like whenever the products are purchased from the manufacturer, they are sold in huge quantity. They are collected in a larger quantity. So the people, consumers cannot be buying like 50 kgs or 100 kgs bag just like that. They will be requiring 1 kg of that product. So allocation is breaking the bigger unit of product into smaller slots. After allocation, N is negotiation, as I have told you. Allocation A, and then S in NASA, S is for sorting. What is sorting? Like when I say dal, there are so many qualities of dal coming. Like so premium quality, then the second grade quality, then the third grade quality. Same way in tea, you have the first quality where you have only the leaf. The second quality, it will be little big granules. And the third one, the very powdered thing, the dust part. So all this grading, all this sorting has to be done according to the quality, size and quantity. That is done under sorting. All these are done, children, in warehouses. All the warehouse plays all these various roles of sorting and all that. So negotiation, allocation, sorting. N, A, S is done. Then again A, assorting. What is assorting? Like see, what normally we do is, the warehouse does is, all these channels of distribution, what they do is, assortedly they buy all type of products. They don't say we buy only the food grains, we buy only this vegetables, we buy only the fruits. They buy all type of products, perishable, non-perishable, assorted. Then they arrange for distribution of this product. They first arrange for storage, then the distribution. So assorting. Next, P. P is for product promotion. They act, they all these retailers, the wholesalers, what they do display of the product in the store. They act as a promoter there. They act as, they play a vital role in product promotion. You would have seen in various departmental stores, there will be some stalls put up for various products and advertisements and banners for various products. So these wholesalers and retailers, they act as a promotion agent for the product. So product promotion. Again, next A is accumulation. Larger homogeneous stocks. This means when you go to a retail store, they don't say that I have only toothpaste, I have only toothbrush, or I have only noodles packet, I have only the grocery. It's not like that. Every retailer, every wholesaler have in his shop all type of items. All the products you need is available under one roof. That is because of accumulation. They accumulate all type of stocks, enabling the consumers to buy near their place. The last but not the least is the risk-taking. So there may be a demand for some product at one point of time and suddenly the demand may go down. But these retailers, wholesalers, all these channels of distribution, they take the risk. They buy the product very much beforehand. They won't know whether the product will be in high demand after a few months or the demand may go down. But they take the risk. They invest money. They buy the product. They keep it in the shop. So they balance the demand and supply actually. So please remember this, functions performed by channels of distribution. Remember the acronym NASA at par. So remember negotiation, allocation, sorting, assorting, NASA at, and then par. P for product promotion, A for accumulation, risk taking is for R. Hope it is clear. Types of channels of distribution. Here I've just given you some examples, children. The first one is direct channel, that is zero level. I sell my product directly, like MACD. Everyone will be able to understand if I say MACD because it's a direct channel. MACD, Bata and all, they sell their products themselves directly. Direct selling to own MACD and all, like a direct selling through own retail outlets. MACD, Bata, they have their own outlet, they sell their products. selling through own sales force like Oriflame, Amway, AquaGuard. They have their own sales team. They don't sell it in the shop. You don't find Oriflame products like that. So they have their own team of people, team of retail outlets which can sell these products. Mail order selling, here I've given you the example of Reader's Digest. Please remember. Internet selling, of course, everyone will be familiar with this because that is what we are doing nowadays. We buy only through online, Amazon, Big Basket, Grofers and all that. So types of channels of distribution, direct channel, that is zero level. You sell directly your products, selling through own sales force like Oriflame, AquaGuard, mail order selling, internet selling. Remember all these examples what I've given so that you can just understand what it is. Okay, under types of channels of distribution, in the previous slide, we were discussing only about direct channel. Direct channel, these are all the types. Direct selling through own retail outlet, selling through own sales force, or mail order selling, or internet selling. All these are direct channel. In the second slide, it is indirect channel. Under indirect channel, you have three levels. One is one level, manufacturer, retailer, consumer. One level. Two level is manufacturer, wholesaler, retailer, consumer. Three level, manufacturer, agent, wholesaler, retailer, consumer. Just remember this picture for this levels of channels of distribution. The last one, last P we are going to discuss is promotion mix. What are all the promotion mix? What are all the combination of promotion tools? How do we promote our product? We have done everything. Okay, the distribution channel is decided. We have transportation is arranged, warehousing is arranged, but how do I promote my product? So these are all the techniques you can choose. Advertising, personal selling, sales promotion, public relation. When I talk about advertising, you can advertise in media, you can advertise in internet, television, radio, magazine. The most popular means of promoting a product is advertising because it will reach a huge number of people at the same time. And advertising, what are all the important terms you should remember here is, it's an impersonal form of communication which is paid for by the marketer, like sponsor. There are some sponsors who take up this advertising function to promote the product through newspaper or television. Features of advertising, paid form, sponsor has to bear the cost of communicating with the prospective buyers. Impersonal, advertising creates a monologue and not a dialogue. What does it mean here, features? Monologue, advertisement never waits for you to respond. They just advertise the product. You just see the advertisement. Then it is left to you to decide whether to buy or not. They don't ask. You don't interact when the advertisement is played. So advertising creates a monologue, not a dialogue. Identified sponsor. Advertising is undertaken by some identified individual or company. There are some advertisement companies who do only this task of advertising the product. Next, personal selling. Door to door. People go and sell the products. Personal selling, but nowadays, we can't even imagine a personal selling because we have to keep distance, maintain 6 feet distance. Social distancing has become a key factor nowadays. So personal selling, but personal selling door to door, go convince customers and sell the product. And then sales promotion. Sales promotion is the widely used promotion tool. You have every time you see that end of season sale, 50% off, exchange offer and all that, the various techniques of sales promotion. So you can just go through this GIF what I've given here on the screen. How sales promotion techniques are like, you give free samples, you give discounts, you conduct some contest, you ask the customer to fill up the form. Okay, you have a holiday package given if you buy some product. And if you buy a TV, you are given one mixie as a free product for that. Or if you buy 1 kg, you are given 0.5 kg free along with that. All these are sales promotion techniques. Next, public relation, very important concept. How the image of the company should be kept in the eyes of the public. What do they look upon when they look upon our product? So just maintain the company's image, protect the company's image, interact with the media, see how it is, and find out what is your product, where it is in the market, and provide some additional features with your product and ensure that your product is in the market and it is contributing to some causes like child education or towards saving environment or towards the society. The product is playing some vital role. Which tool of promotion will primarily be used for the following? First one, to promote or protect a company's image or its individual product. So whenever you see the word company's image, immediately remember public relation. An existing product meant for mass usage by literate people. Okay. Then it should be definitely advert. Whenever you see mass usage, immediately go for advertisement. To introduce a new product to a particular class of people through door-to-door visit, definitely personal selling when it comes door-to-door visit. To attract attention to of the people by using incentives. Whenever you see the word incentives, sales promotion. Here I have just given for your reference this for today's session. I didn't make actually mind map. Here I have given you the curriculum for marketing chapter because children are confused with what is there and what is not there for the marketing chapter. Please, this is the CBSE curriculum for business studies 1920 for the marketing chapter. I have just put it on the screen here. Just go through this. You will have marketing concept, functions and philosophies as I discussed. Marketing mix, the concept and product, then product branding, labeling and packaging concept. When it comes to price, concept, factors determining price. Physical distribution, concept, components and channels of distribution. What do you mean by physical distribution? What are all the components of physical distribution? Then channels of physical distribution. Then promotion, the concept and elements. Then advertising, please remember, for and against advertising and all is not given in the curriculum this time. Same way, sales promotion techniques not to be prepared. And then public relation, you just have to know the concept of public relation. That's it. Role of public relation is not mentioned. Just make a note of this curriculum. I'll just show you the previous slide. You can just make a note of this. This is what you must study. The various types of products is given in the NCERT book. Even the types of products are all omitted for you. You need not go through. Please make a note of the curriculum and mark everything in your textbook so that you need not get confused. And the marketing chapter, as I have done now, it's not very vast. It's really easy for you to read it. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, ma'am. It was a great pleasure hearing you. And definitely students would have got benefited. And we have been seeing the content of the marketing chapter. I still vividly remember my BCom marketing subject. So wherein I read only 2 to 3 days and then was able to appear and write the examination. Definitely, I think students have already studied the marketing chapter in the +2 and it will definitely help them in the graduation. Thanks a lot. And now the floor is open for the question. And students from Tycoon Academy can ask the question.
Shivraj,
please unmute the people who are raising their hands.
Good evening, ma'am. Can you hear me?
Put ma'am on spot later. Huh?
Yes. Sir, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. Go ahead.
Yes, ma'am. Actually, my BS sir has told me that functions of a distribution channel and those the topic and all is not there, ma'am. But it was there in the presentation. So am I supposed to learn them too? Because my sir told for sure that it won't be asked.
No, please remember one thing. This is the latest curriculum. This year we have followed. All of us have followed the same curriculum. Just make a note of this. Whatever curriculum I've shown in the slide, everything, whatever is the content there, everything is included.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you.
Okay. Narayanan, Tycoon Narayanan.
Sir, can you hear me, sir?
Yeah.
Ma'am, good afternoon, ma'am. My doubt is that and sometimes there will be a confusion in under what can be marketed. Sometimes there will be a bit of confusion under what class it comes. For example, when we take amusement parks,
okay,
there will be a confusion between whether it's the experience they're promoting or the place itself.
That is what I told you. See, when I say experience, it will be clearly explained. You have to read the case study. When you read the case study, you will understand whether they are asking for the place For the place, normally they go for the various cities and all that. But when they say experience, it will be clearly mentioned. When you read the case study, it will be definitely clear for you what are their focus, what are they focusing. And if you want, later I can just send some example for this through your academy. I can just send some case studies which can be shared with you.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Right. Tycoons, you can go and ask questions. The floor is open for the questions. It can be random also. No problem. Unmute yourself. Go ahead, ma. Tycoon Harivallabha.
Sir, can you hear me, sir?
Go ahead, ma. Yes, ma.
Ma'am, we heard that the selling concept is not included in the syllabus. Is it true?
Yeah. I have not mentioned it in the curriculum.
Okay, ma'am. That's nothing.
Marketing and selling, you need not know the difference. And same way, you need not explain marketing management separately, marketing management concept separately. Whatever I've shown you in the curriculum, this is the curriculum given by the CBSE this time. So whatever is the selling concept, you need not learn it separately. And no need to learn the difference between marketing and selling also.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Next. My dear friends, any more question you can ask randomly, no problem. You can unmute yourself and ask.
Ma'am, namaste, ma'am.
Namaste.
I have a small doubt, ma'am.
Yeah.
The classification of products, that is the consumer products, industrial products, those are not there.
Not at all included. Don't have to go through even once.
This okay, ma'am. Okay.
Omitted totally. It was omitted long back.
Okay, ma'am. Okay. Thank you, ma'am.
Next, my dear friends. Teju, yes, ma. Tycoon Teju.
Objectives of advertising and role of marketing.
Objections and objections against advertising, for advertising, everything is omitted. Nothing has to be learned. You just have to know what is advertising, what are all the features of advertising, as I showed you in the slide today.
Okay, thank
you. So I think majority of the content, what you are all worried about, you have come to know that all those things are not included. So the chapter has become quite small now.
Yes.
Trivikram, go ahead. Thank you, Trivikram.
Ma'am, I think the problem is like the curriculum. I think it would be helpful if you send over the basic. We are confused about it, ma'am.
No,
we're all.
I'll tell you one thing. Just log on to CBSE.
Ma'am,
Trivikram, can you mute yourself? Some vegetable vendor has come to your home.
Okay, CBSE website. Log on to CBSE website, children. All otherwise, I'll just send a copy to the.
Sorry, ma'am. Sorry, sir.
No problem.
No problem. CBSE website, you just download. You can just download the curriculum for business studies 2019-20. All the chapters, you can look into the content and then you can start preparing. Or I can share it with Satya, sir, so they can forward it in the group.
Yes, ma'am.
Tycoon Vita Sudarshan, question. No question. You studied everything, I know.
Not like that.
Hey, you unmute, man. Yeah.
Sir, should I say thank you now?
Tycoon Dashneet Grover. You have no doubts, ma? Can you come on the video?
Either the session should have been very clear or the...
yes, Neet. Yes, she's coming on.
Or it should have been too vast.
I think they're very clear. They studied everything. They're just waiting for the exam to come.
Yes, ma'am. Very clear.
We are and all acronyms, I think definitely you can remember.
Vishwas is taking notes. Pasta. Running notes.
Very nice.
Sudarshan also. Next. Mukila, you have any questions?
No, sir.
Okay. That means you'll get 100 marks in marketing.
I will try, sir.
Right. All right. I think most of the questions are answered, ma'am. I think it was self-explanatory in your session.
Thank you, sir.
Only thing, if it had been live, then people would have asked the question on YouTube. But what we will do is we have recorded. So we will premiere this session today night, so that it will go 8 hours and campaign will go in the night.
Okay.
So by the time it will go to all the students' groups.
Definitely.
Yeah, yes, ma'am.
Any other doubts also for them in any other chapter, let them just ask Tycons.
Right.
Tycons can always approach me for any doubts. And
definitely. Time. Definitely. Definitely, ma'am. So my dear friends, we have to thank Kavita Amma for dedicated service. That too on a Sunday, she is into valuation of the papers. She is managing the family, then three. She is working in a school and she is preparing a PPT. Please understand, if you ask me to come and I do multiple sessions in a day and I never carry a PPT nowadays because it's pain to prepare a PPT. It's not easy. And she was asking how to prepare a beautiful PPT. We were using, Surya sir is using some technology. She's asking with that kind of a dedication, she's trying to help you all. And I hope you will all use this opportunity and really fare well in the examination. And I was just sitting and listening to it. At least when I studied the CA Foundation, at the time management, marketing and all was there as part of it. Really, I didn't learn this much. That's a fact. So I have to accept. That's a fact. Not this much. This much understanding I didn't get. So your curriculum is so strong. But I'm sure this will help you a lot of ways. Only thing, you should know the practicality of this subject which is being taught in the plus two. Definitely will help you. The concepts there will help you. And you have a management, the commercial knowledge section in your... CA, commercial knowledge section, will anyway be part of the management things. And management is something which you should know. It is not a theory. For business studies, not a theory. It is a practical paper, actually. All the subjects you may master, accounting also, technology will go. Technology will come and overtake. Economics anyway, not much of application. You have the mind of economics, mind of economist. But business studies is one thing which you practice. So management, leadership, planning, staffing, so this and all is a practical thing when you build an enterprise. But by default, when you apply these concepts, I'm sure you'll all revere the teachers who taught you in the plus one, plus two. Today, we run the CA classes for all of you in the foundation level. We were able to do this job only because they created the base. Otherwise, it's not possible. If you have to start from the 11th standard is very difficult and LKG is very difficult. LKG, UKG, very difficult. First standard, okay. Second standard, the students will pick up automatically. LKG teacher, UKG teacher, first standard teacher, 11th standard teacher, we have to salute, especially commerce teacher. Okay, because you should never ask the meaning of a double entry system of accounting. Right? You just understood what they told you and you start building on it. If you keep questioning, you would not have learned it. So I think we have to give the credit to the teachers who are trying to create you. And the batch on batch, they are into the mission of creating the transforming these students. And I think we have to thank the teacher community who is helping us. They are all experts in the examinations. So I want you to maximum utilize this. This will be in the YouTube repository of Tycon Academy. And I'm very happy that you people should make use of it for revising. And also pass it on to your juniors who are now studying in 12th. So that they also get benefited out of this recording. All right. My dear friends, tomorrow we have Unni session. And I request all of you to join the session. You can invite your parents if they are free. If they are in work, they can log in from there. They can witness Unnikrishnan speaking to you all. Unnikrishnan is a very good family friend of us. And second thing, Unnikrishnan will be coming and highlighting and discussing about various art form. Just a second. There is one box that has come. I have to pick up. 1 second. You just receive the receipt and then do it. So, my dear friends, so Unni will come and address you all tomorrow and make use of the best opportunity. And we have a revered Swami Vimurthananda Maharaj who will come and highlight you. He is the head of the Ramakrishna Math of the entire administration. He takes care. He will address you. And we have Suresh, the industrialist, and a leadership message from Apresh Acharya, my guru for leadership, who was a Dale Carnegie trainer. He has also given a special message to all of you. Tycoonize magazine has already reached the respective people who should appreciate it. They have already appreciated. And Prakash Narayanan wanted to change the title of the topic. You can welcome to do it. No problem. You speak to the team, magazine team, and then do it. Kavitamma, we also welcome you for the tomorrow session. Sure. And please participate, and then you can pass on the invitation to a limited number of people who could come and participate. That will also be live telecasted in the YouTube and it will be visible to the larger audience. In fact, a lot of demand for Unni session to attend in Zoom, but we are restricted the admission to the Tycoon students because there should not be much confusion inside the Zoom room. So it will be available in the YouTube. So people can view the YouTube. Parents can join. Tycoon Academy students' parents can join and witness the launch of Tycoonize magazine. I have to appreciate all the students who have put their heart and soul into Tycoonize magazine. Excellent article. Yesterday, I sent to Belur Math your article on the plague manifesto, especially the last paragraph. I think Sister Nivedita wrote this article. How Sister Nivedita sweeped the... Am I right, Sister Nivedita?
Yes, sir.
Sweeped and then you written it very, very, you know, that detail was so good. And then last paragraph was so good that you concluded with the present situation of corona, how to handle it with that plague manifesto. It is definitely a great dimension that you have provided, and people are appreciating that article.
Thank you so much, sir.
And Rukmini's interview, Srinath's parents' interview, Ganapati's one of the articles, then we have Sai's article on technical matter, that NPA issue, very good, huh? NPA issue, yes, analyzed very well. And of course, Sudarshan has written one article. Then you have one more, the Viveka, that sloka written by Jairam. Yesterday I sent that sloka also. So I went through the entire article, entire magazine 2 times. Really excellent. Good design, very good design, and very good name you people have done. And I'm sure this Tycoonize will take different, it will take its own avatars, batch by batch. And I request only one thing to you all. Personally, I don't know any of these things. This is the truth. Surya sir sees me and he put me the printout on my table. And he said, I have to see it yesterday night itself. I saw it in the yesterday night, completely read through it, point by point. I was so happy. And you ensure that this gets handed over to the juniors, batch by batch, month by month, so that it become. And let me tell you, one day you will feel proud that your article appeared here. Tomorrow after 5 to 6 years, you might write an article in Economic Times. Your articles will be opinion maker in the country. But that opinion first started only in Tycoon magazine. So we give opportunity for public speaking. We give opportunity to write articles. So make use of the maximum benefit of it. Apsara wrote one article. That is also good. What is that article you wrote? With your signature. Apsara wrote an article. Right. Usha Chomar, very wonderful article, man. Wonderful article. Next month, you please carry Arunachala Muruganandam. He's my good friend. In the same lines he has worked, Arunachala Muruganandam. You know, the pad man of India, whose story has become a Hindi movie. Akshay Kumar, correct. He's my very close friend. Okay, he's very close friend. I have shared sessions with him. I'll send a photograph today. He was a Time. By the way, he was a Time magazine. He appeared in Time magazine as the powerful man. So people who are aspiring to appear your name in the Time magazine, you should be your inspiration. So next month, you will put up his Time magazine article. Along with that, you will write his industry name is Jayashree Industries. So I've interacted, I have shared session in Coimbatore session in La Meridian, I suppose. We had a session together. I spoke on government's initiative and he spoke on the inspiring entrepreneurship. Maybe you should carry. So let it go. You'll evolve it and hand over safely to the juniors who are coming in. It is your responsibility and this will be done. You'll feel proud one day that you people are the people who started this, and when you look back, it will be a great credit, and I'm sure people who are contributing proactively will win in the things. And I want people who are not contributing, people who are not able to write. For example, I'm not a good article writer. This is a fact. But there will be somebody who will be writing for me. I will speak and they'll write. Nowadays, there is an app that has come. If I speak, automatically article comes. The Grammarly verifies. These are all the tools available. So if somebody is finding it very difficult to write, somebody can interview them and write their article. But they may have a good content actually. I'm sure there are people like that in the class who doesn't know how to write an article, but who can speak well. So get them, because I see myself in them. Okay. Surya writes an article. He will not speak. But I cannot write an article. I speak. It's a fact. Okay. So there are different personalities who should be given opportunity. So think about all those things and think how do we groom and position yourself. Very important. Don't leave that also. Okay. Just because you're supporting somebody, you should support somebody, also position yourself. Both should happen. Think win-win. You got the point? So that should be your attitude. Right. My dear friends, it's all tomorrow class will be there. No, from 8:30 to 9:15, 8:30. And 11 o'clock is the session. My dear friends, tomorrow morning class will be there. Just because Unnikrishnan is coming, that does not mean class is not there. 8:30 to 10 o'clock class will be there. From 11 o'clock to 1 o'clock, Surya? Max 1 o'clock, Unni session will be there. After that, you will go and take rest. Oh, Sai, oh, Abdin. 1 to 2, you will take rest. 1 to 2, 2:30, you will take rest. After that, I will carry, because morning I missed 1 hour, no, 2 hours. I will try to complete that and Surya sir will complete rest. Okay. And to inform you all, we are getting new admission. His name is Mr. Srinivas, who spoke in the morning. You all know Srinivas, no? Today morning he spoke.
Sir, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
He is taking up both CA and CS. And he's going to set a new benchmark. I will prove that. He will sit for 10 hours. Okay. And he will prove. He will solve the problem visually in his mind, and he will orally solve the problem. I'll bring to that level. That is Surya's responsibility. He will be much good interpreter of the law than you. I assure you that, because today I just spoke after the session. I didn't speak to any other student. I spoke only to Srinivas. Out of that, today's session I got a gem. Srinivas mark in 10th standard is 499 out of 500, right? And in plus 2, he got 430, in 11th, he got 435 out of 500 or whatever. Okay. And by the way, is visually challenged. And I'm taking him. Okay. And I'll prove that he will set a benchmark for you. And if God's grace is there, he will get a rank. He will. And I am given that open. I throw open a challenge to him. He said, he only wanted to do CS. I said, why CS? Try to do CA also, no? And he's the brother of Akshaya, Madhuri Akshaya. So Madhuri Akshaya is now enrolling CS because of him. Right? She has got the duty. She's the mentor for him. So if I have to scold, means I'll scold Madhuri Akshaya only. Akshaya, you're there?
He's not there.
So you'll convey the message to her.
Yes. Okay,
so she will do it, and I'm sure he will. Srinivas will emerge, and I myself spoke to him personally, and I'm sure both will emerge in the same attempt very successfully. And Srinivas should not stop. You should all inspire him every time, because I will not be there all the time. So you should inspire him to make sure that he qualifies UPS examination. So you should, that aspiration I've already given. He will take up BA history. This is what I counseled him after the session. I got a gem today out of the session. Others, I don't worry. And we did not speak the way they will join. You know better. Half of the people would have ran away. All right. Anyway. So. So, my dear friends, let's all look forward to Srinivas joining us tomorrow, and Akshaya will take care. Right? Let's all welcome Srinivas tomorrow. And by the way, thanks a lot, Amma. So, hearing us today, what we are discussing, and I want you to be there tomorrow in the Umi session.
Definitely.
And you have been a great supporter. You've been a great supporter for us.
Congratulations to all the tycoons and the tycoon mentors.
Right.
For the launch of the magazine. Well. I'm really happy about this.
You saw that, Ma? You saw the magazine?
No, I don't know.
Okay. Sudarshan, you should show the magazine as it gets released.
Sir, officially release aata adukapram.
Sir, okay pa, purinjuchu
pa. Sorry, we are under the same roof. Everything has to be done.
He maintains. Yeah. Formally, launching. Man of rules.
Man of rules always.
Yes. Happy. Thanks a lot, Amma. Thanks a lot. And I would request Tejaswini to sing the Guru's tribute to Amma, and then we'll close the session. Thanks a lot, my dear friends. Please, you can cut the live. Oh, she has cut the live already. My dear friends, you are attending yoga classes. Last week, you attended. So, please practice. And as you practice and complete, please put a message in the group that you practice yoga. I want everybody who is attending a yoga class, and people who are not attending yoga, it's your wish. But people who are attending a yoga class, please put me a message. Please motivate me also. Okay. Motivate Surya sir also. I keep motivating Surya sir, and Surya sir motivates me. Okay, when I'm having lunch only, you will motivate me. Okay, when I'm having lunch only, you will motivate me. Okay, so I want you people to practice yoga, and please send a message after you do the yoga. Morning, some student got up at 5:30 and has messaged me. Sir, I'm doing yoga. Did you get up? Yoga. Right? So please put that you did yoga means put you did yoga. Stay committed to it. So you should also take care of your physical well-being. You study little. For example, you put 10 hours class, and 9.5 hours effective. Or half an hour, abdi irukla. Onnum prachin illa. Another half an hour yoga pannidunga. Okay? Please, no problem. Even if you compromise on your education for 1 hour, 2 hours, no problem. Do your yoga. அதுக்குன்னு 8 hour யோகா பண்ணிட்டு என்னடா யோகா பண்ண நித்ர யோகான்னு சொல்லாதீங்க ஸ்லீப்பிங் யோகான்னு சொல்லிடாதீங்க ரைட் மெடிடேஷன்ல இருந்த சார் எத்தனை மணி நேரம் 8 hours சார் சமாதியில
இருந்தேன்
ரைட் சோ அதனால தயவு செஞ்சு இட்ஸ் ஓகே யூ டெடிகேட் 1 hour 2 hours இன் அ டே இட் வில் டெஃபினெட்லி டேக் யூ ஃபார்வர்ட் ஐ அம் டெல்லிங் யூ இட் வில் ஹெல்ப் யூ அ லாட் இட் ஹெல்ப் யூ அ லாட் அண்ட் இட் வில் ரீசார்ஜ் யூ எவ்ரி டே அண்ட் டூயிங் யோகா இஸ் அ ஃபேஷன் இட்ஸ் அ ஃபேஷன் ஆல்சோ So if you say, I'm doing yoga, you are representing the UN's cause, right? So please do it and Shivarishi ji will coach you part by part. Repair பண்ணிட்டே வருவாரு. கை ரிப்பேர் பண்ணிருக்காரு இப்போ. கொஞ்சம் கொஞ்சமா தலை ரிப்பேர் பண்ணுவாரு. அவர் கொஞ்சமா ரிப்பேர் பண்ணி சரி பண்ணி விடுவாரு 10 கிளாஸ்ல. அது மட்டும் பண்ணுங்க 10 கிளாஸ் முடிஞ்சதுக்கு அப்புறம் அட்வான்ஸ் ஸ்லோவா எடுத்துக்கலாம். So please pick up the yoga and people are already doing some asanas. This would be a specialized asanas. Please understand. That will be like Surya Namaskar means universal. Everybody will do. But how to take care of the arms, how to take care of the neck, those things only is teaching. Health is wealth and please make use of this opportunity. Right? So 1 hour per day you dedicate and then try to do it. And please motivate me also and Surya sir also. Thanks a lot, my dear friends. Thanks a lot, Kavita Amma. It's wonderful to have you always. It's a pleasure having you always.
All the best to all the students for their exams.
Thanks, Amma. Thanks a lot, Amma. Thank you. Amma, as Amma leaves, we'll all stay in the session and then close the session. Thanks a lot, Amma. Thank you, friends. We have to wind up. I have a session at 6 o'clock today in Chinmaya Mission, Coimbatore. I have to address the some of the people, students, some youngsters are coming from different parts of the country. I have to address at 6 o'clock. If you wish, you may join. I'll send the invitation. The Zoom ID also will be there. It's, if you're busy on Sunday in the evening, I know you will be busy. You can carry on your work. Thanks a lot, my dear friends. Thank you.
Sir, excuse me, sir. What is the topic, sir? That 6 o'clock session.
என்ன டாபிக் ஒரு செகண்ட் இனிமேல ப்ரிப்பேர் பண்ணனும் பாத்து சொல்றேன் இரு
ஓகே சார்
ஒரு செகண்ட் சின்ன மிஷன் ஏய் கேரியர் இன் தி கேரியர் இன் தி 21st சென்ச்சுரி தி நியூ நார்மல்
ஓ ஓகே சார் ஓகே
ஓகே ஓகே சோ ஐ வில் பி டிஸ்கஸிங் இன் டீப்லி அபௌட் தி டிஃபரண்ட் கேரியர்ஸ் தட் வில் எமர்ஜ் ஆஃப்டர் கோவிட் 19 ஓகே யூ கேன் அட்டெண்ட் மேன் இஃப் யூ விஷ்
ஓகே சார்
ஓகே தெரியும் நீ வந்துருவ 5 மணிக்கு வந்து உட்கார்ந்து பாருங்க தெரியும் உன பத்தி சரி அதனால தான் உங்களுக்கு இந்த செஷன் சொல்றது இல்ல வந்துரு
தாங்கறோம்
Okay, so you can participate. Anybody who wishes to, I'll pass on the message in the group. Okay, thank you, Pa. All the best.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.